Hello guys, I'm Saras Azad, and to no surprise, I'm a writer. So friends, I'm here to talk about my journey as a writer, the challenges that I have faced in my life as a writer, and the lessons that I have learned during this journey, so that you can also learn from me. It is said that a success story cannot teach you as much as a failure story can. So as far as I can remember, there are two memorable moments in my life. So the first one, when I finished my first book, Lovely Revolution, it was finished in 2013, and I was so much confident of that book that I thought that I would send it to any publication house, any famous publication house in India, and it will be taken with open hearted. And the second memorable moments, friends, I would say that it was when I talked to my latest publication house, which is Red Grab Books. So I talked to the owner of this publication house, Venus Kesariji. So for the first time, I talked to a person from a publication house, and in the very first conversation, we talked around some 45 minutes. Friends, in my opinion, a writer should be like a mirror to the society. So I always choose a subject. So there are a lot of ill practices that happens in the society, that goes on in the society. There are a lot of challenges common people have in their life, be it a rich man, be it a poor man. So everybody has some or the other challenges in their life. So I write about those challenges. I write about those ill practices which still take place in the society. So for example, if I take example of my latest book, Vibrally Romance. So the story of this book is based on caste system in India. So I would say that fame came very late to me. So it is very precious to me. And of course, when your work reach a lot of people. So becoming famous means your work is reaching a lot of people. A lot of people are reading your book. So it is of course very much encouraging, it is very much satisfactory that what I have written, since I write for the society, and if it is reaching a lot of people, so it is very much satisfying, and it motivates me to write more. Okay guys, so I would say that first of all, you should ask this question to yourself: why do you want to write? So whether you want to become a writer, you want to become a poet, you want to become another kind of artist, so you should ask this question to yourself, that why do you want to become that? I have seen that a lot of people want to become writer, to become famous. A lot of them want to become rich by earning money out of it. So people who are dreaming of such kind of things, like somebody is writing just because he want to become famous, somebody is writing just because he or she wants to earn money out of it. So my message to those people, that stop writing right now, because unfortunately you are not going to get anything out of it if you are writing with that purpose. Your purpose of writing must be clear. In my opinion, you should be writing for the society. As I said that a writer has a lot of responsibility towards the society. If you have become a writer, you should be like a mirror to the society. So you give something to the society, you write for the society, and society will automatically give it back to you. So let me tell you that my book, launch of Vibrally Romance, which was released in August 2019. So it was managed by Just Event Management and Promoters. So my experience with Just Event and Management has been fantastic. I had not expected this much audience, first of all. The kind of arrangement they had made and the kind of interaction was there. The most important thing was there. That the kind of interaction was with the authors. So it was a launch of two books along with my book Vibrally Romance. There was launch of another book, Jaipur Diaries. So the moderator was so much engaged with the writers that it was completely a different experience for me, completely a great experience. And I'm sure that if in future I would like to work more with the Jashn Events, especially Seema ji. So Seema ji, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to come on this platform and share my experiences with you. And at the end, I would say that thank you very much for listening to me, for giving your time to me, and good luck.